guests, Professor Dr. Avi Subedi, Professor Hemanda Rajdahal, Principal of Budhanilkantha School, Vice Principals, Acting Chief Administrative Officer, all the teachers, our dear parents, guardians, and all other well-wishers present here this afternoon. On behalf of the entire Budhanilkantha School family, I would like to welcome you to our annual school play 2019, The Murder Mystery at the Murder Mystery. First written by Brian D. Taylor in 2013, this play within a play is a rip-tickling comedy mystery, widely known for its mind-twisting plot and lovable characters, set in the small town of Detroit. It's a busy evening at the Detroit Mystery Playhouse. The characters are rehearsing their new show, putting a little English on it, which is to be staged the next day. And the entire playhouse is a disaster. Everything seems to be going haywire, from the unexpected blackouts, to the terrible piano refrains and the sounds of thunder when there's no storm outside. And the players are quite distressed, to say the least. Things take a turn for the worse when one of the characters, Gary Ferguson, gets killed, stabbed with a fire poker through his chest. The crew is left scratching their heads as they try to figure out who the murderer is, and they call the police to help them solve the mystery. Things seem to be going well, but it all goes downhill when the two inspectors are killed in the same fashion, when they replay the scene after Gary dies. To their utter annoyance and disbelief, they find themselves playing the scene over and over for a set of new characters in the hope of figuring out who the murderer is. But each blackout, accompanied by a clap of thunder and an awful piano riff, results in their death in the same manner. A fire poker impaled through their chest. The entire playhouse is in shambles until the arrival of Brian D. Taylor, the playwright himself. The characters eventually unfold the mystery of the murders, and it all comes down to an unexpected finale, where all of them must race against time to save themselves, and possibly the fate of the entire playhouse from the murderer's wrath, before he serves them all a bloody fire poker death. So sit back, relax, and enjoy for the next hour and a half, a delightful, engaging, and mind-boggling spectacle, which is sure to leave you in stitches. I would also like to request the audience to maintain silence and switch off their mobile phones. Thank you.
What was that?
Oh, just knowing what a trifle of thunder. Nothing to worry about.
But why should that make the lights go out?
Why? It's only a surge in the electric zone.
He's quite right. It's nothing to get up all shambles about. So sit down and finish your tea. Another puppy can go at you.
Yes. Thank you, Mom.
Anyone else? It's an old family recipe passed down from my great-great-grandmother who worked in the king's kitchen and was in there to die for.
Right about that, though.
Oh, my!
Responsible. going on? Erica, is there a problem?
Working on it. This year, so it's never going to win.
Settle down now, Scarlet. We'll be rolling again in no time.
In no time? Huh. I seriously don't have time for this.
We'll be done sooner if you stop talking and work on the lines. Well, that is the problem.
Work on my lines? Don't you know who we're talking to?
Thank you, Scarlet. Now what is up?
Is everything okay in here? I heard raised voices.
Everything's fine.
Are you sure? Nothing out of the ordinary?
Scarlet and Brett are to eat the toad again tonight. I feel that's about as normal as it gets.
Nothing to worry about, officer. Everything is under control.
Okay. But no one should hesitate to call me if someone feels as though they're in danger. If you get my drift.
You'll be the first one to know. Sir? Now will someone tell me what's going on?
The doorbell.
What?
The doorbell. It did ring.
Okay, and?
And we're waiting for it. What is Arby supposed to do? The cue is on Richard's line when he says.
One of us is responsible. There it is.
Good afternoon, I'm Inspector Bradshaw. I do hope
I'm not. Not now, officer. False alarm.
But the doorbell rang!
I know. Just a little mistake, but the problem's solved now. Come with me and I'll explain it. And that's when Gere comes in as the inspector.
So that's all we've been waiting for. A doorbell?
Yes. Well, not anymore.
Oh my, this is just awful. Is this going to happen on opening night? What if this happens on opening night? What will we do? It can't happen on opening night.
It won't, Missy.
But tomorrow night is opening night.
Look, it's fixed. Problem solved. We have a doorbell, and we'll have it again tomorrow for opening. And even if we don't, we'll just keep going. Right? Right? Relax, it'll be fine, I promise.
Brett. Could I have a word while we're stopped?
How could I say no?
You've read my contract now, haven't you?
Yes, Scarlet. I've read it. I've told you 1,000 times that I read it!
Then you know that my contract specifically states...
That you may not be rehearsing for more than 3 hours at a time. Yes, I know.
It's 8:45 already. I refuse to be kept past 10. I must have a beauty rest.
And beauty rest you shall have.
Not that you will do or anything.
If everyone's done, I have a few words.
Oh, goody. What a wisdom from a mighty leader.
Look, we're off track. We have to get through this rehearsal if you want to open tomorrow night. I think what you all need is to take a moment to refocus, okay? Let's all just take a minute to breathe and refocus by visualizing a show-stopping performance tomorrow night.
Show-stopping? How is that different from what we're doing already?
You know what I mean. Just do it. Come on, everyone, close your eyes. Just breathe.
Oh, no.
And visualize.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Good, that's right. Just breathe. And visualize.
Oh, no.
Is there a problem here?
Here we go again.
No, officer, everything's perfectly fine.
Things don't appear to be fine. It's too quiet.
First, it was raised voices, now it's too quiet.
Seriously? We're already running over and it's already getting ridiculous. We don't have time for crazy.
Excuse me? What did you call me?
You heard me. Go back to your beef, you beauty dog.
Oh, I see. Insulting enough now, are we? Well, miss, you've just earned yourself a free night stay at the dead for a jail. Let's see if a night behind bars will change your tune.
No, Gary, not now!
Let him have handcuffs!
Come here, you!
Get him away from me!
Erica!
What now?
Officer Ferguson seems to think there's a problem. Handle it!
Right. Officer, I witnessed everything. I can tell you everything you need to know so you can crack the case.
Aha! Now we're getting somewhere. We've got a tutor. Oh, wait a minute. What should I bust you?
I have nothing to hide. Like I said, I'll tell you all you need to know.
But what about these people?
They won't tell you a thing. They're a primary suspects.
Just as I thought.
Come with me, officer. Wait, but why does everyone keep calling him officer? Gary
make a suggestion?
No.
Well, I was just going to say, perhaps Susan could act as the backup brother.
No.
You know, play a couple of notes that sound like a chime.
Sure, I could do that.
Something like that. Just in case.
No.
That way we wouldn't have to worry about it.
No.
I think we all know that playing needs a little work.
How could you say that? She's sitting right there. She can hear you.
No, no, it's true. I'm sorry. I'm doing my best, but he's right. It's pretty bad.
Well, I think your music is great.
Thank you.
Nice work, kid. You keep telling people what they want to hear and you'll go far.
Oh, thanks.
I'm only suggesting that.
No, Richard!
Well, here's another idea.
No.
What if Gary were to just knock at the door?
No.
I mean, he's standing right there, ready to enter anyway.
No.
And all we need is a signal before his entrance.
No.
All I'm saying is that...
No! Please tell me again, Richard. What is your role in this play?
I'm playing Mr. Polk.
No!
Frederick Polk.
Not what is the role, but what is the role, Richard?
I'm playing.
What position do you hold in this playhouse, Richard?
You're an actor. He wants you to say that you're just an actor.
Right. And I'm the director, so you do the acting, and I'll do the directing. Okay, Richard?
But I was thinking...
No! Don't think, just act, and I'll do all the thinking. Capiche?
Oh, right.
Perfect. Now, can we get back to rehearsing the show, please? I'm so glad we used to let the critics in for a preview tonight.
We're all set.
Are we sure we're ready to go on?
Doorbell works. Gary's refocused. Everyone who needs to be on stage is on stage. Let's go before any of that.
And it won't happen again?
Not a chance.
Good. The rest is you. Places, everyone. We'll take it from Richard's line. We'll have a doorbell this time and there'll be no more problems.
And we'll be done by 10.
Just in time. Are we done?
Hey, look, everyone. Tom's away.
Almost forgot about him.
Is the rehearsal over? Because I'm just dying to track down the pizza truck right about now.
No, Tom, you died just 2 pages ago.
Really? Because it seems like I've been lying here for a while.
That's because you have been hungry.
It's okay, Tom. Go back to sleep.
Okay, cool.
Just
at least I didn't know it was a snack, Rick.
One of us must be responsible.
Whoever could that be?
I'll get it.
Good afternoon, I'm Inspector Bradshaw. I do hope I'm not interrupting your afternoon tea, but I happened to be in the area and I heard a scream.
Sorry, that was me.
Oh, an inspector? Did you come for a scotland yard?
Yes, as a matter of fact. I was just on my way back there when I heard the disturbance. Is everything okay here?
No. In fact, your timing is impeccable, Inspector.
Seems you may have been witness to...
A murder!
A murder, you say?
Yes, sir. It happened right here, before our very eyes.
So you saw everything?
Not exactly. The electric went out just as I was pouring tea and well...
When the lights came on, Mr. Black was... dead.
So you're telling me that you didn't see the killer?
No, sir. The lights went up and it was pitch black.
Interesting. Even in the afternoon?
Yes, sir. I was wondering about that. It is sort of fishy.
And you're certain it was murder?
Yes, sir.
Let me see the murder weapon.
The murder weapon? Of course! It's up right there in Mr. Blaster's. Exactly where we found it. We didn't
disturb the crime scene at all. Everyone knows you never disturb the scene of the crime.
What do you make of it, Inspector?
I can say without a doubt that, in fact, this man was murdered!
Oh, how awful! But who would have done such a thing? We all love that man, Mr. Black. Surely none of us is responsible.
That's certainly a possibility. But until we await the facts, it's impossible to know for sure. As of this moment, you're all suspects.
Oh no, this is awful.
What's the matter, miss?
Oh, nothing, sir. It's just that it's so awful.
Sounds to me like you're guilty of a guilty conscience. Is there something you'd like to tell us, miss?
No!
But how could we have done it? No one would. We would all have an auntie, and we all love Mr. Black.
You keep saying that. Could it be that you don't love Mr. Black at all? Could it be you're the murderer?
No!
Well, someone is responsible. I'm going to have to recreate the crime scene. I need to know exactly who was in this room, what they were doing, exactly when the murder took place.
So you mean you want us to replay the scene as if we're in a play or something?
Precisely. Very well. We can do that, Margaret. Everyone was present, you see, and Margaret was just serving tea.
I was, and I had just poured Mr. Black's cigarette and it looked at him.
Who we said? Drink up, Mr. Black. You don't want your tea going cold now, do you?
I see.
Now, don't go reading into that. I only serve him a cup of tea just like I did for the others.
And what else did you put in Mr. Black's tea?
One lump, just as he requested.
One lump. I see. Please continue.
And I said, oh, mummy, the Bobby gave us something to die for tonight.
I see. So it was the poppy cakes.
What?
The poison. It wasn't the poppy cakes.
No, they were just really good.
And who said anything about poison anyway? Are you accusing my wife of murder?
How dare you?
No, not just yet.
And besides, it is suspected that Sir Black is killing the fire cooker, not by poisoning.
As I was saying, I must have all the facts. Please continue.
Mr. Black began a conversation about billiards. Mr. Polk is a fine billiards player, so Mr. Black asked him about his game. He said, how is your billiards game played, Mr. Polk?
And I said, just dandy, Mr. Black. Care for a round after tea?
Oh, Frederick, always up for a contest. That's what I said.
I think you're a bit grand. Maybe watch. Oh, yes. That does sound exquisite.
I'll just go set up the table, I said. But then Mr. Black said, no, Mr. Polk, I'll love to take a stab at it. I'll play a game or two. But you've always laughed at me, and I'm certain I'll never beat you.
Why is that, Mr. Black? Surely you've improved since we last played. It's been years.
And Mr. Black said, no, I'm afraid I haven't at all. It seems I still haven't quite mastered the break.
Oh, pish posh. It's nothing really. All you have to do is put a bit more English on it.
And that's when the lights went out.
And when they came back on, Mr. Black was dead.
I see. So you were challenging him?
Only to a friendly game of pool.
Now is that a pool with capital P, which rhymes with C?
What?
Nothing.
just trying to remember an old song about boys who are up to no good.
Surely you were suggesting?
No, just trying to understand what happened there tonight. What did you say to him again?
I said, all you have to do is put a bit more English on it.
Gary! might actually be...
What?
Dead.
Oh my.
What a shame.
Oh, but I like Gary.
This is ridiculous.
And we open tomorrow night. Oh, this is terrible.
But how?
Come on, this is a firebugger in his chest. I mean, how it happened is painfully obvious.
But who could have?
Yeah, everyone loved Gary. That's not exactly true.
You can say that again.
I mean, someone has to do something, right?
No, right. Someone should do something. Erica, call the cops. Erica, now, please.
It's over. It's all over.
Calm down, Misty.
No, there's nothing that can be done. The show is over.
No, it can't be and won't. As they say, the show must go on.
But
and it will.
I sort of think that this might be the one good reason to cancel a show.
No, the show must go on. Surely there's someone who can play Inspector Bradshaw. Someone surely knows lines.
And I doubt we can count on you for that.
Me? No, I'm the director. I'm the leader. I'm in charge of the play's vision and direction. I can't be up on the stage.
Just as I thought.
I know Mr. Black's line.
No, but then we have no virtue.
Aww.
Erica can do it. She knows everyone's line.
Red, she's going on the show and fixing all of our problems. You can expect her to pay the inspector on top of everything she's doing.
There's no one else.
And who's filling for Erica as stage manager?
She can do both.
No!
She can!
No! I mean, yes, of course she could do both. We all know how incredible Erica is. But seriously, she's burned out. It is too much to ask.
Fine, I'll think of something else.
In the meantime, what do we do about this?
I don't know.
Now there's a surprise. He finally admits he doesn't know something.
Shouldn't we, you know, drag him into the wings or something?
No.
Are you saying no just because I suggested it? Or you really don't think we should?
Yes.
Because it seems strange to leave him lying here like this.
It didn't bother you that Tom has been lying here all this time.
But that's because it's Tom. Who's playing Mr. Black? Who's dead?
Gary's dead.
Scarlet, don't be so insensitive.
Well, it's true.
But Tom's only playing part in the play. Gary's really dead.
When you think about it, what's the difference, really?
The cops are on their way, and I've instructed the crew to let them in.
Thank you, Erica.
But what are we going to do? What will we say?
We'll just recount the facts. I mean, we're more than Mr. Playhouse, after all. Surely we all know how this works, don't we?
He's right. You should try to remember exactly what happened when the lights went out.
Yes. So, who was on stage and where was everyone standing at the time? What?
You really don't know, do you?
I know. I'm just the director, not the stage manager. I don't keep track of all the notes. Notes, yeah. Erica, you know, please.
What on your light?
Hand them over.
No, what if something happens to them?
Nothing will happen. Everything will be just fine.
That's what you keep saying, Brett. But lots of things are happening and everything's not fine.
These never, ever leave my sight.
You don't have to leave the room. You can supervise.
Fine.
Thank you. Yes. So Mr. Polk was over there. Mr. Polk and Gertrude there. Miss Polly, the maid, and Inspector Bradshaw there. Mr. Black, where the same place has always been. No, there was no one else on the stage at the time. That solves it. One of you must be the murderer.
What about you?
What about me?
You were in here with us.
She's right, Brett. This isn't just taking place on the stage. This isn't a play anymore.
Where did she go?
Susan! Did anyone see her walk out?
What if it was her?
Susan! Seriously? That's impossible.
No, I mean, really. Just think about how frustrated she must be with all of us.
You're right. We have been rather difficult.
She's talking about you.
And how can she live with herself when she plays so horribly?
It's not that bad. I sing the music
really suspect her.
Are we seriously doing this right now? Why don't we just let the cops handle this?
What if she's out there plotting who's next?
Misty, I'm serious. It's not good for us to be questioning each other. We've got to trust each other. We have a show tomorrow. Real people who actually paid for the tickets are coming.
She's right. Maybe we all should just quit talking and wait for the police to arrive. At least, then we have a moment to think about what just happened here. I mean, none of you are concerned about what just happened to Gary.
Good evening. Is this the Detroit Mystery Playhouse?
Yes, officer.
Right. I'm Inspector Wright, and this is Inspector Fuller. Detroit PD, we got a call down at the station about 20 minutes ago, and we came here.
I'll be right back.
What's wrong?
My badge. I think I left it in the cruiser.
That's okay. Fine. Recovered. And I mean you back up.
No. This doesn't feel right. Like I'm searching the place without a warrant or something. I'll just get a memory right back.
Okay. Sorry about that. As I was saying, we got a call down at the station.
That was me.
So, if I'm to understand correctly, there's been a verdict.
Yes, sir.
Mind if I take a look around?
No, do what you need.
So
Gere. He's the inspector.
Just replay the scene that your characters play for the inspector. Inspector Bradshaw, that is.
You mean when Mr. Black died?
Yes, it's all the same as anyway.
Wait, so we get to reenact the scene, just like our characters do? We're method actor, like Gere!
Why did I even tell her?
Are you sure it's the same?
Yes, only Gere was standing there, and he was playing Inspector Bradshaw, the investigator in the play.
All right, fine, I'll just stop. Take a seat here in the front row, and you guys can do your thing.
All right, everyone. Let's take it from Polly's lab. Pick up Mr. Black.
Wait. Is this the original death scene, the one that the characters replay? We'll leave out for that.
All right, wake him up.
Is that the scene we're doing? Maybe I'm confused. What I thought we...
Richard! What have I said?
What I thought Tom was...
No more thinking, okay? Now wake him up so we can get going.
Tom? Tom?
What? Is it time for this next break?
No, we're taking it back a few pages. We need you for the death sequence.
Okie dokie. At least that means I'll get another puppy cake.
No, you can't eat them. We're running low and we need to save some for tomorrow's show.
Okay, fine.
Drink up, Mrs. Black. You don't want your tea going cold now, do you?
Oh, Mommy, the poppy cakes are simply to die for tonight.
How is your billiards game lately, Mr. Polk?
Just dandy, Mrs. Black. Care for a round of tea?
Oh, Frederick, always up for a contest.
I think it'll be grand. May we watch?
Oh, yes. That just sounds exquisite.
I'll just go set up the table.
No, no, Mr. Polk. I'd love to take a stab at it and play a game or two, but you've always bested me in our serving. I'll never defeat you.
Why is that, Mr. Black? Surely you've improved since we last played. It's been years.
No, I'm afraid I haven't at all. It seems I still haven't quite mastered the brain.
Ah, pish, posh. It's nothing really.
All you have to do is
put a bit more English on it.
I know, but I was was so captivated by performance that then the lights went out and everything was dark.
What? The stage lights went out again?
Yeah, just like before. I'm on.
No, young lady. I'm going to have to ask that you stay here in order to convict Mr. Mini Two Shoes here.
Convict him?
I'm going to need to know the details of all that happened.
Whatever you say, officer.
But I really, really, really didn't do it!
How can this keep happening? First, Gary is murdered, and now an officer is killed, and Brett being hauled off to prison. How will we ever open?
Don't worry, we're not opening after this.
No, we are going to open tomorrow, no matter what. You don't need me here, the show gets to go on.
But Brett, this has gotten out of control.
And I'm not staying past 10 tonight. In fact, it's obvious we're going to pitch you with your souls. I guess you could not.
Oh dear,
how exciting.
Oh brother.
No one's going anywhere doing anything until I get all the facts straight. You go and have a seat in the front row. Oh, don't. You won't need to talk.
We can do more than tell you, officer. We can show you.
Here we go again. But we've done this scene 3 times already.
Excuse us for a moment.
Do you want to go to jail?
No!
You see, in his business, just do the scene again like the inspector asked.
He can't hear you, but I can fly!
Perfect. Everyone's ready.
Don't forget Mr. Black.
Alright. Tom!
But he's... Mommy?
Oh my goodness! This is another big one! Oh my goodness! I thought you were dead!
Is breakfast ready?
No, Tom. We're just playing him more this scene.
Oh, again? We've done this scene several times already.
Finally! Someone else sees how ridiculous this is!
Places, people! Places!
I'll just take this scene. Okay.
Think up, Mr. Black. You don't want your tea going cold now, do you?
Oh, Mummy. Talk with yourself simply. To die for tonight.
Who's your billiards game lately, Mr. Polk?
Just deadly, Mr. Black. Careful around after tea.
Oh, Frederick, always up for a contest.
I think you'll be grand. May we watch?
Oh, yes. That does sound exquisite.
I'll just go set up the table.
No, no, Mr. Polk. I'd love to take a stab at it in a game or two, but you've always bested me and I'm certain I'll never defeat you.
What is that, Mr. Black? Surely you've improved since we last played. It's been years.
No, I'm afraid I haven't at all. It seems I still haven't quite mastered the break.
Oh, piss-poss!
It's nothing,
really. All you have to do is put a bit more English on it.
What's happening, guys?
Yeah. That's exactly how it happened.
No.
Exactly
the same way.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? What do you mean? What do I mean? What do you mean, huh? I mean, all the murders are connected. They're all inspectors. Every person killed tonight is an inspector.
Not Tom.
He doesn't count. He's not really dead.
Well, what about Gary? Gary's not an inspector.
No. But Blaze won in the play.
Well, Blaze won in the play.
She's right. Each victim was murdered in the same fashion, stabbed with a fire poker.
One, two, three, four.
Yeah, that's definitely odd. I mean, how many fire pokers could there possibly be in this place?
Oh, and there was thunder and the lights went out each time.
Yeah, what with that?
Who's working on it? But there doesn't seem to be anything wrong.
go out when it thunders. Thunder doesn't knock the power out. It's just a sound.
You know it's the lightning that does it.
Please, Brett, don't treat me like an idiot every time I put up with it, but I won't. Of course I realize that lightning can knock the power out, but it's never just a flicker. Doesn't it usually knock the power out for good for at least a few hours or more?
No, not in any murder mystery I've ever seen.
This isn't a play anymore, Brett. This is really happening to us. She's right, Brett. There's something weird going on with these lights. Oh, and what about the music? It's still playing every time someone's pronounced dead.
Oh, it's so dreadful. It gives me shivers. Somebody cut that part, Brett, please.
How can we cut the music? Susan hasn't been at her keyboard for any of the last three murders.
And yet, the music plays on.
Like the band playing as a Titanic sank.
You guys don't really think?
What?
Oh, I don't mean to suggest. I mean, everyone loves Susan. Well, most of it anyway. But you guys don't think this could be her, do you?
Well, she does seem to have disappeared.
She hasn't been seen since Gary died.
And the music keeps playing.
Oh, that's so cool.
It's like Susan's signature for every murder. Like some sort of vengeful poetic justice. What? I've always been a fan of Susan's work.
Seriously, you guys? Are we seriously pointing fingers at Susan?
But don't let a compass,
who's doing her very best to provide us with all the cheesy mood music.
Well, who else could have done it?
It could have been any one of us, including you, Erica.
Hindsight's killer!
Now, hold it right there! She doesn't mean it, Erica. We all know you're the only people holding the show together.
She's only saying that someone is clearly responsible for this. So why not you?
Who's the one in handcuffs?
All right, about that. Come over here and get me out of this.
Brett, just leave them on him, darling. It's better for everyone if you keep him restrained.
No, come on, guys. Someone get this off of me.
We are done assigning blame. I know each and every one of you, and I know that none of you is responsible for this.
Aww, that's so sweet of her to say.
Can it, cutie? Then who is? Yeah, how on earth did we end up with four dead bodies with five hookers in the chest?
Three. Tom's not dead. You mean three.
Three dead bodies? An actor who's playing a dead body with five hookers in the chest.
But no one did anything to Tom. You just really mean three.
Three dead bodies with five hookers in the chest.
I don't know. She's right. This is weird and scary. And there has to be someone who's killing all the inspectors. Someone must be doing it, whether it's one of us or someone out there.
Maybe I should just call the cops again.
No!
But someone has to figure this mess out.
Oh, you're right. I knew just the person.
Not Erica.
How did you? Fine.
But she's right. We shouldn't be the ones pointing fingers or growing suspicious of one another. Someone else needs to figure this out for us.
Then who?
I've got it.
Not Erica.
I know. Someone else. Who else?
Who?
The perfect person, really.
Who?
I mean, when you think about it, they really know how to pick apart a murder mystery.
Who?
And they always seem to be able to recognize the killer before anyone else does.
Who?
The critics!
Oh, that's a terrible idea.
No, come on, guys, hear me out.
Brett, you know that they'll eat us alive.
They're worried of killing your view that will appear in tomorrow morning's paper.
And no one will come for the opening night. There's at least a chance that people will show up tomorrow if they don't know any better.
Wow, you really think we're that bad?
No, yes, no. Yes. You're all wrong. The house will be packed for sure.
How? We never have a full house.
Because the news story won't be about how terrible our show is. It'll be about, the murder that happened at the murder mystery playhouse. After reading a story like that, everyone will want to come.
But maybe everything is on something here. And you're right, Brett. Theater critics always seem to unravel the plot before anyone else does.
Yes.
They might actually be able to tell us why the inspectors keep dying.
Or who killed the inspectors.
And since a critic is a police officer, they'd be safe, right?
Exactly.
But what if I'm wrong? What if it's not just the inspectors who have been murdered? What if it's all just a coincidence that they're all cops?
Well then, honestly, There's one less critic we have to worry about.
Hey, guys!
Oh, dear, sweetie.
I was wondering if she'd have come back. There's this lady out front, peeking in the windows and trying to get in. Looks like she wants a glimpse at the rehearsal. Says her name's Alicia with the Detroit Daily Tribune.
Speak of the devil.
Alicia's in the theater columnist, isn't she?
Yes.
Perfect. Susan, we are just saying how wonderful it would be if a theater critic were here.
Really? You want a theater critic in here? Haven't you been watching the rehearsals?
Erica, go in there. Fine, I'll just invite him myself.
No, Brett. Let me do this. You're in handcuffs. Just sit down and try to look more professional.
That's my girl.
Oh, that's so cool. Like I've always wanted to read a review with my name in it.
Oh, she'll write something about you. You can count on that.
I see. You all went on with the rehearsal without me.
No, we haven't moved forward at all. We haven't missed anything.
Then, who's this?
Oh, it's not even late.
He's Inspector White from the Detroit PD. He came to investigate the murders.
Oh, I could have sworn you look familiar.
You're probably just mistaking me for Tom.
It's a fire poker. This is a mistake.
So, where have you been all this time, Susan?
Well, since we're on a break, I took a little walk, went down to the corner street, and did a little window shopping. Take a look at this! They had a clearance sale going on cutlery. This baby was only $4.99, and only $30 for the whole set.
Daddy, I'd love to take a stab at it and play a game or two. But you know what?
Why is that, Gertrude?
Surely you proved
since we last played. It's been years, or months, I suppose.
No, I'm afraid I haven't at all. It seems I still haven't quite mastered the break.
Oh, piss posh. That's a terrible way to think about it. I mean, you really shouldn't say that to Gertrude. My precious dear little girl. I mean, you're good. You're really, really good. And it's important that you believe in yourself. I mean, if anyone believes in you, it should be your home, man. Your father. I know you can do it.
Get on with it!
I mean, breaking a rack of buildings' balls is nothing, really. All you have to do is put a bit more English on it. So it isn't storming outside, and the light shouldn't be going out unless There is a technical problem.
There's not. It's been checked and double checked.
And that awful music keeps playing out from nowhere!
No, Susan clearly isn't playing it.
I don't think this is murder. This is something far more dreadful.
Nonsense. I'm sticking with the obvious. It's murder. Some sick lady thing, some sick game with this.
But who?
Hey guys, how's your rehearsal going? Ah, the playwright. He'll be able to help us. I just saw that pop in one last time before opening night. Am I interrupting?
Take a look for yourself. Does it look like you've done your rehearsing tonight?
Who are these people? You're still here to see my play, aren't you?
Oh yes, believe it or not, it is putting a little English on it. It's a hoot, let me tell you.
Then who are they? Brett, did you make changes without telling me?
No, these people aren't in the play.
I know that, I wrote it. So, what are they doing here? Murdered, we think.
And judging by those handcuffs, I'm guessing you had something to do with that.
No, this was just a misunderstanding.
Would someone just tell me what's going on already?
Inspector Fuller thought Brett killed Inspector Wright, who was here to investigate the death of Gary, was playing Inspector Bradshaw. And when they ended up dead themselves, Brett thought we should have Adele Sears give us her opinion, but then she ended up dead too.
And all very fire pokers.
Oh yeah, I can see that.
Don't you find that odd?
No, not really. I've written stranger things.
What?
Do you...
Do you think you could help us solve the mystery? Some of us are beginning to think that we might be... cursed.
Interesting idea.
I was thinking while I'm thinking.
What?
Well, since he's the playwright, write the scene so that our course will be reversed. Right?
I've got this. Oh dear, you've gone too deep into this now.
The murder is often taking place in the play. He could only rewrite it so Mr. Black doesn't die. But Tom's fine.
What? Are we done?
No, of course not. You still don't get it, do you?
But at least you could help us find out what's going wrong.
Can't you?
Maybe. I mean, I'm happy to take a look. Okay, places everyone.
Wait, are you sure we should be doing this again? What if it happens again? It would be just awful if something awful happens to Brian.
What do you mean?
She means you're next.
What? Me?
Well, if the pattern continues, everyone who's come in here has been died. How do we retake the scene?
Oh, well, in that case, maybe you shouldn't. Oh, we'll be fine.
Are you sure?
Yes.
That's not really assuring. Maybe we should just go.
What? Oh, no. Stay. Please. We need to stay. Please stay. Take precautions if you're worried about it. But stay, please.
Okay.
Please. Thank you. Erica, do you have like a helmet or something in the costumes?
I know. Wait, what?
That's my girl. Tom, wake up. We're doing the murder scene again.
Seriously? Are we really that bad?
Yes, but that's not the point.
This ought to protect you.
Yes. Perfect. There's a fire poker on this planet that could prevent that, if you say so. All right, everyone, get your places. Let's try this again. Action!
Drink up, Mr. Black. You don't want your tea going cold now, do you?
Margaret!
Oh, Mummy.
Oh, is your billiards getting lighter than spoke?
Just dandy, Mr. Black. Care for a round after tea?
Oh, Frederick, always up for a contest. I think it will be grand. May we watch? Oh, yes. That is so exquisite. Ah, just
I'll serve you. I'll never, ever defeat you.
Why? Why is that, Mr. Black? Surely the proof has been lost, then. Oh, no! Mr. Black! You poor thing!
Oh, afraid I haven't at all. It seems I still haven't quite mastered the brain.
Oh, piss, pause! It's nothing, really.
All you have to do
is put a bit more English on it.
I knew so. something was odd, and this explains everything.
How?
I knew something was weird when Ryan said it didn't strange things. He said it off the cuff. But what it really meant was it actually written stranger things.
I don't follow.
He meant it literally that it written stranger things than this very play we're all in.
Putting a little English on it?
No, but this play. The murder mystery and the murder mystery. Just think about it. Music cues being off, the regret hearings, the endless fire pokers, Misty's one-dimensional personality.
What?
And not to forget the terrible British accents we've all been using during the play.
What? My accents? Perfection!
Ha ha ha.
What are you suggesting, Richard?
I'm saying that it doesn't add up. This isn't reality. I mean, look. This orange isn't real at all. And we, of all people, should be able to recognize that. We are actors, after all.
So this whole thing, the murders, the curse, the firepokers, it's all...
Yes, it's all scripted. We are characters in a play. No! Yes, it's the only explanation.
So you're saying that...
Yes, well, it's all in the book. Listen. Tom, you know, it's getting kind of late. Are we going to keep going this time around? Holly.
No, Tom, we're done. The show's over.
Tom, what? Holly.
The show's over. The playwright's been murdered.
I don't talk like that.
Whoa, deja vu, man.
Exactly!
Because that's what Tom and Holly said just a minute ago, when Brian died.
Exactly. Those were the very lines. Just stopped off. He killed himself off.
Oh, Richard, don't put it that way. It's...
morbid.
See? See? More strange music. It's the truth. We're all characters in the play.
No! I'm not buying it. I'm more than just a character. I'm the director.
Darling, please. Then you mean we're all someone else?
Yes. You're all being played by an actor.
Well, that's so cool.
But who? You, of course. But not the you we all know. Because that's how an act.
She's right. Since we're all characters, we can never break character. So there's really no way of finding out who we are until the play is over.
Oh, my head hurts.
Oh, I'd better be played by someone fabulous like me.
Sit down.
I wouldn't worry about that. What's more important is we're all safe. No one else is getting murdered here tonight. If we can only finish...
Not so fast. Hand over the manuscript.
Whoa. You're there, but you can't be there. You're back there.
I thought you were dead.
He is. He's right there. Backstage where we carried him. Still lying on the floor. With a fire poker in his chest. Yet, there he is too. Standing right in front of us.
Like the ghost of Christmas past.
No, it's just like Lord Voldemort. Where his face is only to pieces and just keeps coming back.
Nadia.
Oh, good.
Oh,
bye.
I had the strangest dream, and you're there, and you're there.
I said, hand over the manuscript.
No.
I'm the playwright. I created you. You must do what I say.
No, I don't actually. I just have to do what's written. And as do you, I'm not handing the script over.
Give it to me now, Ira. Very painful death for all of you.
So, he's a real playwright and a murderer.
Yeah, that's right. I am.
Then who is he?
Well, that's the Brian who wrote Pretty Little English on it. He didn't kill anyone. Well, except for Mr. Black, that is. I'm the Brian responsible for all the other murders, so you can see. You're all at my mercy.
Wait.
Stop screaming.
You're not the same person. You and him. Him and you.
No, he's just one of my characters. Just like the rest of you.
But why do they have the manuscript of the play we're all in?
I don't know how he got his hands on it, but it's mine.
Oh, you don't know how he got it. How convenient.
So, somewhere out there, you are actually writing this and killing everyone up, one by one. Only to write yourself in the play to save us by writing your own death. Supposedly killing off the murderers. And then, write yourself back and try not to kill us again. Yet, you don't know how your character got a copy of your manuscript. What? I do pay attention to some things.
I haven't finished it yet. It still needs some revisions.
You're really a terrible writer, you know that?
It's unedited. Behind every good writer is an even better editor. But you didn't know that. You're just a terrible actor. No one need to make your words sound better, is there? No! What you think? That right there, that's my job. And I've had enough of this. Get out of my theater, now! I'm not leaving without my manuscript.
Don't let him have it.
Fine, I just take it from you.
You and what army, you're outnumbered.
Yes, except if you're going to want teensy, weensy thing.
What's that?
I've written myself. I'm not just some boring playwright. I'm a guy with superpowers. I can move at super speed. You won't even know what has hit you before I have the manuscript and I'm gone. Stop him now! I am inevitable.
The first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day to eternity if I had a chance to wait. Just to spend there with you. But make days last forever. If words could make wishes come true.
See? You have no power over me! Now I can rewrite the ending and make sure that none of us arrest the fire poker! Ha! Over now! Break a leg! I've got it! Quick! Everyone! Top of the scene!
What?
The scene! Do the scene!
Drink up, Mr. Black! You don't want your tea going cold now, do you?
Oh,
you
mean his game,
lady,
Mr. Polk?
No!
Just then, Mr. Black, yes. Let's run out of the team!
Oh, Fred, you got yourself 100.
I think we're going to win, maybe more.
Stop doing it now!
I'll just go set up the game.
I
think that's...
No, Mr. Polk, I'd love to take a stab at it.
Stop! Quick!
No!
Stop!
Why is that, Mr. Black? Surely the boss is the last thing! It's been years!
Oh, yeah, I'm quite mastered the
brain. Oh, Bish Boss!
No, Bish Boss! No, Bish Boss!
Yes, Bish Boss!
No, Bish Boss, don't you dare!
It's nothing, really!
Don't say it!
Say it to the state! All you have to do is put a bit more English on it!
Is everyone else okay?
Mom? Oh my! Doctor! Mom!
No! Tom? Buddy?
Does anyone know what time the beads are dropped for tomorrow?
You're feeble, Tom!
Well, that's a relief. We did it! Is that what we had to do? You ordered the play, right?
Oh, don't put it that way. It makes us sound responsible.
He's a victim of his own doing.
Well, now it's now.
Are you sure about that?
No, not entirely, but pretty sure. You saw how he tried to stop us when we replayed the scene. He knew exactly what would happen.
Of course he did. He's a playwright.
Wow. Talk about deus ex machina.
Deus ex machina? What's that?
Well, you know in ancient Greek theater...
Save it! It means it's a contrived and convenient ending.
We're so going to be banned by the critics for this.
Who cares? This is so much fun.
All right. Problem solved. Let's get back to work, shall we?
But don't you think it's getting kind of late?
Scarlet, contract or no contract? We're hoping tomorrow we've got a dress rehearsal to get through. We're going off. Let's go, everyone. take it from page 33. All is that. Just as the players are finishing their reenactment of Mr. Black's murder for the inspector. Oh, and we need...
I'll do it. I'll be the inspector.
Thank you, Erica.
Wait, are you sure she should? What if...
No, that's not going to happen. And we don't have time to worry about that. We're going on. Let's go, everyone. Cut. Action!
Surely you're not suggesting?
No, no. Just trying to understand what happened here tonight. What was it you said to him again?
I said, all you have to do is put a bit more English on it.
Ashish,
2004 Abhinav,
2008 Arpan,
2010 Ayush,
2028 Mujin,
2032 Pratik,
2050 Sushan,
2053 Ayusha,
2061 Loniva,
2069 Rita,
and 2070 Richa.
From the stage crew, we have 2005 Abhinaya,
2036 Saharsha,
2138 Ayushka,
2145 Subhan,
and 2158 Sneha.
From the cast, we have 2066 Prakriti as Adele Sears.
One 1158 Utsav as Tom Baines and Mr. Humphrey Black.
1139 Darwin as Inspector Wright.
Oh, this is a fantastic joke!
One 1017 Shreya as Erika Stone. 2070 Saurya as Holly Hanover and Mrs. Margaret Polk.
2166 Anushka as Susan Wells.
What? I do pay attention to something.
2063 Megha as Sandy Smith and Gertrude Polk. Prinsa as Scarlet Maze and Miss Polly.
Ha ha ha!
1088 Jenisha as Misty, Gere and the Maid.
It's all over! It's all over!
Two 2009 Avanish as Brian D. Taylor, the playwright. Chauhan as Inspector Fuller. 1025 Amulya as Inspector Bradshaw and Mr. Gary Ferguson.
Now is that a fool with half a beat? Just want some tea.
1129 Araj as Red Donahue.
Stop! Stop all of this! I'm more than just a character, I'm the director!
And 1141 Hrishav as Mr. Richard Green and Mr. Frederick Polk. From Light and Sound, we have Mr. Kailar Vasnit, 1020 Sikriti,
1057 Shriyansh and 1038 Mukunda. From art direction and backdrop, we have Armanandar for his expert touches. In light and sound, we have Mr. P.S. Kotel and Mr. D.P. Chapai. From props and stage management, we have Mr. C. Sharma and Mr. G.D. Joshi. In costume and makeup, we have Mrs. B. Lama, Mrs. N. Cha, and Mrs. G. N. Chalmers. As the directors, we have Mrs. C. Dolma, Mr. K. Bhusal, and Mr. B. Sharma. And as the overall coordinator, we have Mr. N. Nepal. As the prompters, we have myself, 1166 Kriti. And myself, 1175 Harika. I'd like to request Mr. Biptop Pore to come up to the stage and say a few words.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I represent the audience here, and like everyone, I've been amused and amused by the play. You know, it was quite brilliant. And unknowingly, you know, we all have been a part of the play, and we just don't realize it yet. You know, because you know we were part of the play along with these guys, and these guys are representing characters that were already a part of another play. So it's like Inception, you know, play within a play. And the one thing that I've been disappointed is that since we're part of the play, we should all be getting one t-shirt, right? Because it's been a long play and we've been sitting there so quietly, you know. It's the hardest thing to do, like Mr. Black, you know. He's been sleeping all the time, that's the hardest thing to do. The person can move from one place to another, it's easy, but standing still in one place and doing it for a long time, it's quite difficult. And another thing is that the play reminds me of, I forgot, another book, you know, where the characters of the book and the writer, they're in constant battle against each other, you know. The characters start writing their own story and the writer is writing his own story. And ultimately, it matters that who finishes the story first, right? And another thing that I would like to compare is that the writer comes into the play and his characters, like his products, you know, the characters are his products and they are like retaliating against him. It's similar to the thing that all of the people right now, we are retaliating against God, because there's a common thing that we either blindly believe in God or we don't at all. And that is something that I got, you know, from the message from this play, because we all know that we are the product of God, but there is freedom among us, for us, that we should believe him or not. But I have been seeing a lot of things going that we are blatantly like criticizing God, and it's been a culture like not believing in God, but that is something that it should be free, you know. Imposing religion to one, imposing the feeling, imposing something is very bad. And that we can see from the play, you know, the writer is imposing the characters to do something they are not wanting to do.
That is an amazing. I'm a theatre person and it takes so much time to prepare and get one actor on the stage. Lots of efforts and understanding. And I don't want to name particularly any, but the acting of everybody was very brilliant, and especially of some of you was marvelous. I have a desire, a temptation to take some of you out of here and put it still there and make part of the theater. Because it's very difficult to It's part of the education. We have been doing it, producing artists, actors, and so on. And the message of the play was very successfully put across. I am a playwright, by the way. I have written several plays, and many directors have staged my plays. Sunil Pokhrel has directed most of my plays. And we have performed all over the world, some of the plays. The question that this play addresses is the perennial conflict between the playwright and the actors and actresses. So this debate is always going on. But this is not a serious debate, but a comic debate. It's a kind of a very light-hearted debate. But in that, that also is a subject of big discussion nowadays. I don't want to make it a kind of academic discourse, this brief few words I'm speaking. Those who teach literature, those who teach theatre, those who perform on the stage, they always deal with this very question of the authority of the author. How much is the author responsible? And how much freedom does the director have? And how can the actors and actresses play their own role? This is a very, very, very important debate that is happening in our world of theatre, world of drama and so on. And you have done it so well, and I'm very impressed, happily surprised. Thank you for giving this surprise to me. Sitting here, Hemantadal, the principal and others, everybody that I met outside, they were excited about this, and they were very rightly excited. I would like to meet the directors of this play, those who directed the play. And you two of you are the directors.
First of all, I'd like to thank Professor Abhi Suveri for giving his valuable time to us for our annual school play. And similarly, I express my deep gratitude to Professor Hemadraj Dahal. He accepted our invitation, and he encouraged us by watching our annual school play. I'd like to thank all the parents for coming up here and enjoying this play. I hope all of you enjoy. I'd like to especially congratulate all the performers, cast and crew members, all of you for producing wonderful and amazing play this afternoon. Congratulations. Let's give them big round of applause for the marvelous performance, mind-blowing performance. Congratulations. My special thanks and congratulations and appreciation goes to all members of the English department who are working so hard, making untiring effort to make this play and to make this show happen so successfully. Thank you very much. Thank you once again, Professor Dr. Abhi Suveri. He is my guru as well as the student of my own grandfather. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, my guru.
The cast and crew, along with the English department, would like to express our gratitude to the following. Special guests, Professor Dr. Avi Suvedi and Professor Hemantaraj Lahal, for coming all the way here and encouraging us, especially the students, with your presence. We'd also like to thank the principal, vice principals, acting chief administrative officer, and Mrs. Shobhana Chetri for all their support, and Mr. Ganesh Simansina, Mr. Mohan Pradhan, and Mr. D. Singh for helping us with the props. We would also give our thanks to Mr. Vishnu Paudel and Mr. Bhim Bahadur Buratoki, along with the maintenance department, Mr. Bhishmaraj Thapa, along with the kitchen department, the light and sound department, Mr. Uday Prasad Kota and Mr. Kapil Bhandari, the school gardeners, Mr. Lakshmi Shundar Talbuti and Mr. Krishna Bahadur Dama, the school carpenters, 101 to Nandita, 1019 Smithi, 1077 Sweksha, and 1120 Susmi for helping with the makeup, Kamana Books and Stationers, and the Council of School Prefects. And last but not the least, we would like to thank the parents, guardians, and well-wishers for their presence today. We hope you enjoyed the show as much as we did while performing it for you. Thank you all very much, and we wish you a relaxing evening.